Narwhals are fascinating creatures that inhabit the cold waters of the Arctic. In this video, we'll explore everything you need to know about these elusive whales, from their distinctive tusk to their diet, mating habits, and communication methods. You'll learn about their natural habitat, behavior, and whether or not they are endangered. So, if you're curious about these magnificent creatures, sit back and join us as we dive into the world of narwhals. By the end of this video, you'll be a narwhal expert. What is the purpose of the narwhal's tusk? The narwhal's tusk, also known as a tooth, is a unique and fascinating feature of this marine mammal. Growing up to 3 meters in length, it is actually an elongated incisor that protrudes through the animal's upper lip. Despite being a tooth, it is not used for eating, and its purpose has been a topic of debate for many years. One theory is that the tusk is used by male narwhals to assert dominance during mating season. They may use it to joust with other males for the chance to mate with females. Another theory suggests that the tusk is used for navigation, acting as a type of sensor to detect water temperature, pressure, and salinity. Recent research has also suggested that the tusk may play a role in communication, with narwhals using it to make clicking sounds and echolocation. Whatever its true purpose may be, the narwhal's tusk remains an intriguing and mysterious aspect of this amazing creature. Where do narwhals live? Narwhals are fascinating creatures that are native to the Arctic regions of the world. They are found in the waters surrounding Canada, Greenland, Norway, and Russia. These elusive whales prefer to live in icy waters, where they are well adapted to the frigid temperatures and the unique conditions of their environment. Narwhals are known for their ability to navigate through thick ice using their sonar abilities. They spend most of their time in the water, but they also come up to the surface to breathe air through their blowholes. During the summer months, they migrate to areas where the ice has melted, allowing them to hunt for food more easily. While narwhals are not commonly seen by humans, they are an important part of the Arctic ecosystem. They play a critical role in the food chain, serving as prey for larger animals such as polar bears and killer whales. Understanding where narwhals live and how they survive in their environment is key to their conservation and protection. What do narwhals eat? Narwhals are carnivorous animals that primarily feed on fish and squid. Their diet can vary depending on the season and their location, but they tend to prefer fish such as Arctic and polar cod, as well as squid, shrimp, and other crustaceans. During the summer months, when the Arctic sea ice melts, narwhals feed near the surface of the water, where they can easily catch fish and other prey. In the winter, when the ice forms, they dive to deeper depths to feed on larger prey. Narwhals have a unique hunting method where they use their long tusks to stun their prey before consuming it. They also have specialized teeth that allow them to catch and swallow their food whole. Overall, narwhals are opportunistic feeders and will eat whatever prey is available to them in their habitat. They have adapted to their environment to become efficient hunters and are an important part of the Arctic food chain. How big do narwhals get? Narwhals are medium-sized whales that can grow to impressive lengths. Adult males are typically larger than females, with an average length of 16 feet and a weight of up to 3,500 pounds. Females are slightly smaller, with an average length of 13 feet and a weight of up to 2,200 pounds. Narwhals are also known for their unique tusk, which is actually a long, spiraled tooth that can grow up to 10 feet in length. However, not all narwhals have tusks, and some may have shorter or broken ones. Narwhals' size and weight can vary depending on factors such as age, sex, and overall health. Like many marine mammals, they have streamlined bodies and are adapted to living in cold waters with thick blubber layers for insulation. Are narwhals endangered? Narwhals are a unique species of toothed whales that inhabit the Arctic waters around Greenland, Canada, and Russia. They are currently classified as near threatened on the IUCN Red List of Threatened Species, which means they are at risk of becoming endangered in the future. The main threats to narwhals are climate change, hunting, and human activities such as oil and gas exploration. Due to their limited distribution and low population size, narwhals are particularly vulnerable to these threats. Conservation efforts are being made to protect narwhals, such as implementing hunting quotas and establishing protected areas. It is important to raise awareness about the endangered status of narwhals and take action to preserve their unique and fascinating species. What is the lifespan of a narwhal? The lifespan of a narwhal varies depending on several factors, including predation and habitat. In the wild, narwhals can live up to 50 years. However, their lifespan is often shortened due to hunting, entanglement in fishing gear, and other human-related factors. Narwhals are also vulnerable to climate change, which can impact their habitat and food sources. In captivity, narwhals have not been successfully kept, and their lifespan is not well understood. Due to their unique physiology and specialized needs, it is not recommended to keep narwhals in captivity. Scientists continue to study narwhals to better understand their lifespan and the threats they face in the wild. Efforts are also underway to protect narwhals and their habitat to ensure their survival for generations to come. How do narwhals mate and raise their young? Narwhals are known to mate during the summer months in the Arctic waters where they live. Males compete for the attention of females by displaying their tusks and emitting whistles, clicks, and other sounds. When a female chooses a mate, they will swim together closely for several days, engaging in courtship rituals that include touching and rubbing against each other. After a successful mating, the female will give birth to a single calf about 14 months later. The mother will nurse the calf for up to 2 years, during which time the calf will remain close to its mother and feed on her milk. As the calf grows, it will start to eat solid food, such as shrimp, squid, and fish. The mother and calf will form a close bond and communicate through a variety of vocalizations, including whistles, clicks, and buzzing sounds. Once the calf is weaned, it will be able to fend for itself and will leave its mother to join a pod of other narwhals. Do narwhals live in groups or alone? Narwhals are social creatures and are often found in groups, known as pods. The size of these pods can vary from a few individuals to several dozen, with the average size being around 15 to 20 narwhals. The pods are typically made up of males and females, with males sometimes forming smaller subgroups. These pods tend to stay together for extended periods, sometimes even for their entire lives. However, it is not uncommon for male narwhals to venture off on their own or join another pod temporarily. These solo males may be looking for new mating opportunities or simply exploring new areas. Similarly, young narwhals may also temporarily leave their pod to explore their surroundings before rejoining them later. Overall, while narwhals do have some periods of solitude, they are generally social animals and tend to form close-knit pods. These pods offer protection, companionship, and opportunities for mating and socializing. How do narwhals communicate? Narwhals, like many other marine mammals, rely heavily on vocal communication for various social and environmental purposes. They produce a variety of sounds, including clicks, whistles, and pulsed calls. Narwhals use these sounds to navigate, find food, avoid predators, and communicate with one another. They have been observed using different types of vocalizations depending on the social context, such as during courtship, aggression, and group coordination. Additionally, narwhals are known for using their bodies and postures to communicate, especially during social interactions. For example, they may use their tusks or flippers to convey dominance or submission. Recent research has also suggested that narwhals may be able to detect changes in their environment and communicate with other individuals about those changes through their vocalizations. Overall, narwhals have a complex and nuanced system of communication that helps them thrive in their Arctic environment. Do narwhals have any natural predators? Narwhals, as large marine mammals, do have natural predators. Orcas, also known as killer whales, are known to prey on narwhals. These highly intelligent and adaptable whales are found in the same areas as narwhals, and they are capable of preying on larger marine mammals. polar bears have also been observed hunting narwhals, although this is less common. Polar bears will wait at the edge of a breathing hole, waiting for a narwhal to surface before attacking. However, polar bears are more likely to prey on other marine mammals such as seals. Apart from orcas and polar bears, narwhals are also at risk of being hunted by humans. Indigenous communities in Canada and Greenland have traditionally hunted narwhals for food, clothing, and other purposes. Today, hunting of narwhals is regulated to protect the species and ensure their long-term survival. And there you have it, everything you need to know about narwhals. We hope you found this video informative and enjoyable. If you did, please consider giving it a thumbs up and subscribing to our channel for more exciting animal content. We'd also love to hear from you. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions for future videos, please leave them in the comments section below. And if you have any personal experiences or stories about narwhals that you'd like to share, we'd love to read those too. Thank you so much for watching and supporting our channel.